Good morning, friends, and welcome back. You all might remember Allison from our really cool anaconda exhibit tour. Well, we are going to be here in the Freshwater Gallery with Allison again this morning, but not to check out anacondas. We are going to be seeing a different animal in our Freshwater Gallery, our poison arrow and poison dart frogs. Now, the reason we wanted to show you this exhibit from the front is that actually this exhibit has a secret from the front. And that is, if you look very carefully at the glass in this exhibit, it opens. It is a door, it's a secret door. How cool is that? Now, we open this exhibit from the front for a couple of reasons, mostly for feeding and maintenance. And the reason that we have to do that is because tree frogs need a lot of vertical space. So this exhibit actually goes almost all the way to the ceiling, which means it's a lot easier to access from the front. So that's what we're gonna see today. Allison's gonna feed some of our poison arrow and poison dart frogs. And at this point, I'm gonna turn it over to Allison to do her thing.
Hi everyone, nice to see you again. So I'm gonna go ahead and open up the exhibit. I have the frog food here. We'll talk a little bit more about that later, but I'm gonna be giving them some live fruit flies. We'll go ahead and get the exhibit opened. All right, here it is. So I'm going to go ahead and distribute the fruit flies around the exhibit, and then you guys can take a look and watch the frogs eating. Why don't you guys come up here and take a look?
Amazing, how cool was that? Well, at this point, you're probably really curious all about what Allison was feeding those frogs. And fun fact, out in the wild, poison arrow and poison dart frogs get the toxins in their skin from poisonous bugs that they eat in the Amazon. However, our frogs are eating food that we grow right here in-house. So at this point, Allison, should we take them behind the scenes to learn a little bit more about frog food?
Yeah, I think we should.
Awesome. All right, welcome back behind the scenes. As you can see, Allison and I have moved locations, and we are here to talk a little bit about frog food. So, Allison, can you maybe tell us where we're standing and what on earth is on these shelves?
Yeah, sure. So we are now behind the scenes in the Freshwater Gallery. We're actually standing behind the frog exhibit that we were just feeding at. And this is sort of our food prep sink area, but it's also our fruit fly culture area. So that's what you see here with all of these jars. So we culture a couple different kinds of fruit flies to feed to our frogs here because they'll only eat live food. So we have to keep these on hand at all times.
So fruit flies, that's what we're feeding our frogs. Is that the only thing that our frogs are eating here at the aquarium?
No. So aside from the fruit flies, we'll also feed them little itty bitty tiny crickets. And then other than that, we'll also culture other things like springtails and bean beetles and isopods to put in to the exhibit, either for the frogs to eat or for a cleanup crew in the exhibit.
Awesome. Now, you keep using this word culture.
Yeah.
So can you maybe explain to our viewers this morning what you mean when you say we're culturing flies?
So culturing just means that we have an ongoing population here, so we never need to purchase new flies to keep our population going. So the way that works with fruit flies is that every week we will set up new cultures using some of our adult fruit flies, and they'll actually breed and make maggots and create more fruit flies, and so we just keep that cycle going. So what you see here is actually the different weeks. So we have week one, week two, all the way to week four. And so we'll keep cycling through. Usually we'll feed the oldest fruit flies. And then these are the newest cultures that were made just a week ago.
So if you were nice and up close, and maybe we can get you a nice up close view of this, you'll notice that the jars that are up in this week one section, you're gonna see lots of little white squirmy things, and those are those maggots that Allison was mentioning. But as we move further into weeks two, three, four, you're gonna see a lot more adults. Now, Allison, I've heard there's something a little bit special about these flies so that they don't buzz around the exhibit and drive you all nuts. Can you tell us what's special about these fruit flies?
Yeah, so all of the fruit flies that we culture here are actually flightless. They either do not have wings or their wings are not strong enough for them to actually fly, so we don't have to worry about them escaping and buzzing all around the aquarium.
Perfect. That sounds like an excellent plan. Now, growing bugs, is that something you ever thought you were going to have to do, taking care of aquatic animals?
Honestly, no, but yeah, that happens a lot here.
And are the frogs the only animals that are eating insects here at the aquarium?
No, so we actually have a lot of different animals that like to eat insects and bugs. So a lot of our smaller reptiles and amphibians like to eat them. And we'll also, aside from the fruit flies, we get things like mealworms and earthworms and like crickets and stuff like that. So smaller reptiles, amphibians, a lot of the fish actually like to eat little worms and crickets. And even our shorebirds like to eat some live bugs as well.
Awesome. Well, there you have it, my friends. We are growing bugs to feed the frogs and lots of the other animals here at the New England Aquarium. I just want to say thanks again, Allison, for giving us another really cool sneak peek at an animal here at the aquarium. Next time you guys come visit us, make sure to check out our poison arrow and poison dart frogs from the front. Look for the secret door that we use to feed the animals. If you have questions about our frogs, about growing bugs, about Allison's job here at the aquarium, put them in the comments. We will answer them for you. If not, tune back in tomorrow and we'll see you again soon. Bye, friends.